The various surgical options for single ventricle depend initially on how much blood flow there is to the lungs and is there obstruction to the body.
The strategy for single ventricle can really be distilled down to a plumbing problem.
This is not an operation that creates a normal heart.
We can't fix the heart.
We cannot make another pumping chamber.
What we do surgically is rearrange things, close holes, make connections.
So that you can have blood going to the lungs and blood going to the body with only one pumping chamber.
But that isn't the same as a normal heart.
By rerouting the plumbing, we normalize the circulation.
And that procedure that does that is called the Fontan operation.
And that operation is common amongst all the single ventricle patients. What is different between these various categories is what is done in the first few days of life.
It really boils down to how you're gonna get blood flow in an unobstructed fashion, without any resistance, to either the body or the lungs.
In category one, where there's obstruction of blood flow to the body, one will have to undergo a Norwood type operation to allow for unobstructed blood flow to the body.
And the principles of that operation are to connect everything so that the one good pumping chamber has to pump to the body. So you have to connect the arteries to the lungs and the body in such a way that all the blood goes out to the body without any obstruction.
The aorta is usually too small. So we correct that by putting a patch on to enlarge it.
And that's done by connecting the pulmonary artery, which comes from the right ventricle, to the aorta, and then usually putting a patch on to finish the connection of those two blood vessels and enlarge the aorta.
In addition, you have to prevent blood from backing up inside the left side of the heart. So you have to cut out the partition between the two upper chambers of the heart. And then the third principle of the Norwood operation, or the first stage operation, is to provide some restricted blood flow to the lungs.
What we call pulmonary blood flow. And we do that by placing a shunt, or a small tube, from one of the systemic arteries, or arteries that goes from the heart to the body, to the pulmonary artery.
That is enough flow that you can get enough oxygen in the bloodstream, but not so much flow that you have resistance problems, because that resistance is what prevents you from doing any further surgery.
In other forms of single ventricle, such as tricuspid atresia or pulmonary atresia, you have blockage of blood going to the lungs.
If one falls into the category in which there's obstruction of blood flow to the lung, then one will need a shunt.
So if the pulmonary artery is too small, or it doesn't form, or one of the valves that leads to that artery doesn't form, then you need to supply blood flow to the lungs. And we usually do that through the formation of a shunt.
The idea being to control how much blood goes to the lungs, but allow blood to get to the lungs to mix in the heart.
In category three, if nature has allowed for such, if there's adequate blood flow to the body and to the lung,
you may have a single ventricle with no blockage.
There are children who have a type of single ventricle where there's unrestricted blood flow to the lungs and no obstruction to the body. In that situation, if you were just to leave that after birth, these children would get more and more flow to the lungs because of the resistance dropping, and then they go into heart failure. As that happens, the body tries to protect itself by creating a high resistance in the lungs. And that, of course, is the worst thing you can have for single ventricle, because it prevents you from doing the final operation, the Fontan operation.
One thing that we can offer to infants is to put a band around the pulmonary artery, which is just a ligature that is placed around the pulmonary artery and then tightened down, and allows then restriction of blood going to the lungs so that babies get enough blood and have adequate oxygenation, but not so much that we flood the lungs or damage the lungs because of excessive pulmonary blood flow.
The banding procedure to limit blood flow to the lungs is a surgical procedure. Although people have started developing bands that are adjustable, they're still typically put in by surgery.
There are some children who have what is basically a perfect balance between the arteries to the lungs and the arteries to the body in such a way that they have no obstruction of flow to the body, but they've controlled how much blood goes to the lungs with some narrowing at some point in the pulmonary artery.
And that group of patients can actually have their first heart surgery when they're older, usually around 4 to 6 months of age.
He predicted that Joseph probably would not need that first surgery.
Because of his makeup, the blood was actually mixing very well. We actually didn't have to go through the first stage operation.
That group will still require two heart surgeries to get through the pathway of palliation for single ventricle, but they're lucky they get to miss the neonatal procedure.
So therefore, there are either two or three surgeries that are necessary depending upon the category that you fall into.